so its gentle presence has been acknowledged for many centuries now. From here, the stream travels south to meet the Stour to the north of Blandford Forum. There's an atmosphere in the countryside here that you'll no longer find in more manicured and managed counties. It's a feeling of old and spiritual values lost, mixed with a taste of magic and the surrounding history of Iron Age forts, ageless cultivations, and the haunts and hideouts of prehistoric man. Perhaps as far back as 150,000 years ago, when he first trod on Dorset soil. Together, these characteristics give the county a mood which is unique to it and to it alone. A mood of permanence, security, and civilization. From Derweston, on the west bank of the Stour, Frank Angel can walk to work in Stourpane on the eastern side over a footbridge, which crosses the river close to where the Ewen stream joins the Stour.
Well, when I walk to work in the morning, it's super across those meadows, you know. And the other day I saw a duck with six youngsters, and also I sort of have a chat with the fishermen. It's really good, and I enjoy that. Most of the time I almost get hindered with people. They all want to chat to me and one thing and the other. So.
Frank's father and grandfather both laboured on farms. And one of 13 children, Frank started working on Havlin's farm in Stourpane as a dairyman in 1953. Today he's slowed down just a bit, now he's 71. But he still helps keep the garden in good trim, even in the driest of dry summers.
When Mrs. De Morgan bought the place, it was like a wilderness here. We had elder bushes and sting nettles up high there, stung our face with it. And so we sort of, he asked me to come and help him, and we sort of took it to tackle and got it how we wanted it in the end. And, it was a good challenge. When you're growing vegetables, you've got to make sure that the soil is very fertile, and you've got to put plenty of cow manure on it and make it rich. And then I think that's the secret of growing vegetables for showing, because there must be some sort of guts in the ground to make the vegetables grow. And apart from that, keep them whole and clean, weed free, and it's good fun. I like the old vegetables. I think they're very interesting and worthwhile.
Hello, Frank.
Oh, hello.
How are you doing?
Morgan. Oh, fine, thanks. Yeah.
What are they looking like?
Oh, wonderful.
Do you think they're going to be all right for the show?
Well, they're
going
to have to go in another class because they're bigger this
they're
year.
Much they're much bigger.
Yeah.
Much bigger.
They're going to be more than half a pound this time.
Well, do you think we're going to have any to go into the smaller class?
Well,
they all look so good.
Yes, don't they?
Oh, I hope we're going to beat Anthony Bailey this year. His are always enormous.
I know they are.
But, I know.
Yes, they do look fine this time. Yes.
Good. So, I must say, you've done jolly well with them.
Yeah, I've nearly got them all done now, you know.
Great.
Coded over.
Great.
But cool. They're lovely, aren't they?
Well, Frank, I'd really like some coffee.
Oh,
would
yes,
you?
Please, Mr. Morgan. That'd be
right.
Fine.
I'll get you some.
Thank you very much.
Come on, Dizzy.
John Manifield shares his home in Ewen Minster with his wife Wendy and two beautiful cats, one of which is too shy to come outside. It's surprising to learn, therefore, that his work is entirely devoted to dogs. John learnt his skills with Alsatians as an RAF police dog handler. Wendy was working in the Air Force signals at the time, and now together they train as many as 400 dogs a week.
Don't just sit and stay. Now come out and into the centre, please.
I like dogs because they're simple. They're simple creatures. They just want to please their owners. If they're treated properly and treated fairly, then they give so much enjoyment, far more than anything else. And really, for the cost of upkeep of a dog, the enjoyment they give is it far outweighs anything.
Dog gets up next time you do that, gets a little twitch on the collar, just a little twitch. Makes you a bit tougher. Okay, we're going to do the same this side. Tell the dog to stay nice and firm. Come to stay. Come out to me, please.
First of all, you've got to appreciate that you're dealing with a dog, not a child. It's not a logical creature. It's a simple associative animal. And therefore, if it's rewarded for doing something, the odds are it will think about doing it again. If it's made uncomfortable for doing something wrong, then the odds are it will think twice about doing that again. So it's a simple associative system. The problem, I think, with the average owner is getting them to appreciate just how the system works. Too many owners either are too soft at the wrong times or too hard at the wrong time. They don't quite get the balance right of operating a dog.
All right, we're going to now show you emergency down, the reason why you need them and how to do it. Four stages in emergency downs. The first one requires you to put the dog down, pen here. When it's alongside of you, easily, pen down.
We don't have time to have dogs. If you have dogs, they take quite a commitment. And remembering that we are touring around three counties, really, doing dog training classes during the course of a week, then the dogs would do two things. They'd either be staying at home or they'd be carted around in cars. And we wouldn't want that. I suppose we could use them to demonstrate, but I'd much rather take other people's dogs off them to demonstrate, to show them that they can do it, that their dog can do it.
Down. And the fourth stage is to put the dog down when it's moving. Pencombe, good girl, good girl. Down, down. Clever girl, that's a good girl. Oh, that's clever. Sit. Good girl. Good girl. Right, we're going to do a relay race. Remember, lots of enthusiasm. When the one in front of you gets to the end and sits, the next one goes. Are you ready? Off you go.
Come on.
Come on.
The old adage about giving an inch and taking a yard, whoever wrote that must have been talking about dogs, because it's absolutely correct. If you give a dog an inch, it will take the old proverbial yard without a doubt.
Just down the hill from the underground source of the stream, Pauline Paul's garden in Watery Lane, Ewan Minster, basks in the August sunshine. While Ken tackles the weeds, Pauline sketches flowers, because in her studio beside the house, she makes her living painting plates, tiles and vases with all sorts of different styles, techniques and fashions.
It all started about 15 years ago. Where I used to live, there was a lady who did china painting, and I was having a conversation with her, and she suggested that I go along to her and she would show me how to do it. And I had done some watercolor and some oils previous to this, but as soon as I saw it, I just fell in love with it. There's so many different techniques, so many different ways of achieving things. And also the fact that until it goes in the kiln and is fired, if you make a mistake, you can wipe it off. So you haven't got that horrible pressure of, am I going to get it right first time? Having all my china on display, it perhaps is a little bit precarious, but the grandchildren when they come, or children in the village, they never ever have broken anything. They seem not to need to be told that they mustn't touch it. And the only piece broken was broken by me. And it happened to be one of the most expensive pieces of china I had. So who's the clumsy one? It's certainly not the children. Probably I'm very biased. I've been to lots of other places and they're beautiful. But this area seems to have everything that I personally want. The spring around this area is gorgeous because I can go out and I can sketch. Also, we get beautiful autumns here. We're not polluted, we've not got a lot of traffic. It's just an ideal environment.
Oh, they come out.